Hey everybody, it's Jasmine, and today I'm bringing you guys my review on the Sailor Moon X ColourPop collection. I was lucky enough to snag everything on launch day, and you guys don't know how much I was perspirating because I was so scared I wasn't going to be able to snag this collection, but I did, and I'm so happy. My package came within 2 days after I even placed the order, so it came in super fast, so I'm really happy to just share everything with you guys. Embedded in this review, I'm also including these swatches, and I'm also doing close-up shots as well, and in the end of the video, I'm doing two different tutorials, so one inspired by Sailor Mars, which is my favorite Sailor Scout, and then I'm also going to be doing one inspired by Sailor Moon herself, and I'm also going to be whipping out a wig too, so that's gonna be really interesting. Also, if you're new to my channel and you guys didn't see, I have some videos dedicated to my Sailor Scout looks. So if you wanna see those, then I will have them linked up above in the video, in the iCard, so that you can watch them after this video. To start this review, let's talk about the price. Now, the entire collection was $89, and I ended up using an influencer code just so I could get some money off, and I was able to use the code Shay, and she's one of my favorite ColourPop reviewers and person on YouTube. I really do love her. And that brought it down to around $80. The tax, though, was $7. So instead of paying $89, I paid $87. I saved a whole $2. What about that? How about that? I love that for me. So let's go ahead and start with the palette. Now this one here is called the Pretty Guardian palette. I want to base this review on more of the actual formulas itself as opposed to the packaging because I feel like a lot of the reviews that I've watched so far really emphasize on the packaging. So let's go ahead and give it its light just a little bit. You get the shifty packaging, which I think is really cute, but the formulas inside, we got something to talk about. Here in this palette, ColourPop did not change any of their formulas. It's the same buttery, soft, blendable eyeshadows that we are all used to. And I'm really referring to the mattes here. The shimmers are amazing, and there are three shimmers. So that's gonna be the shades Silver Crystal, Full Moon, and Luna. You also get the addition of two formulas. So you get the Super Shock formula, which is in the shade Silver Millennium, and then you get a pressed glitter in the shade Mare Serenitatis. And those two, to me, aren't the best in this palette. I feel like if you compare it to the So Jaded is a little bit more buttery and a little bit more easier to pick up with your fingers. This one, I just feel like even the Super Shock shadow isn't soft enough. It's still really soft because I always refer to it as room temperature butter. It's still like that, but if you're really nitpicking, this one isn't as soft. And even with the pressed glitter, I feel like with the normal ColourPop palettes, if you swirled your finger in and you lifted up your finger, you would have a fingertip full of glitter. But with this one, it's almost like it's not wet enough because it just seems like when I do that, I have to really go in. And at that point, you're kind of moving all of the product around in the pan and it's not that great. So then you're still left with a pretty glittery eye look, but it's not as buttery and smooth as the other ColourPop palettes that do have glitter. I don't really like to base my eyeshadow reviews based off of touch because some of these do feel a little dry to the touch and they're not as pigmented when you are swiping your fingers in, but with a brush, I guarantee you that you are going to get a really nice eye look, and it is a buildable color scheme because you are working with softer tones, so you are going to have to go back and reapply, but honestly, I don't mind building up my shadows because I feel like I get more control that way. I know some people are like, give me the pigment. I want it now. Give it to me now. On this one, I feel like those shades that will give it to you now, you know, you're looking at probably the purple here, which is going to be the Miracle Romance shade. Love and Tuxedo Rose, I think those three are going to be probably the most pigmented. I mean, they're all pigmented, but I mean pigmented in a way where you are not going to have to build it up so much. In the grand scheme of things, I think that this is a great palette because in my mind, listen, Serena, Usagi, who, however you refer to her as, she's in middle school. And I just feel like if this were real life and you were in middle school, this is an easy palette to wear. It's a really easy palette to work with, and I just think it's safe. It's a safe palette. It definitely fits in the color scheme with Sailor Moon, because let's take a look at her, okay? Let's take a good look at this middle schooler. We got the nudes. Hello. Hi. She's in middle school, like I said, so they're safe shades to wear. They're great transitions. We have the yellow to represent her hair. We have the glitters because, hello, she transforms and there's always glitter during the transformations. And then we have the purple and then the pinks, and that is when she's Princess Sailor Moon or Princess Serenity or Queen Serenity. There's always some types of pinks or purples, period. I just think that this is a great color scheme. Yes, they could have done blue and red to match her school uniform and also her actual like transformation uniform here, but you know what? I ain't mad at it, and I like the color scheme, so that's on that. That's on Fighting Evil by the Moonlight. I lost 3 subscribers. The blushes, I think, were the first to go on launch day. I think these sold out within a minute, and it was actually kind of crazy. So these ones also have the shifty photos. You do get 3 photos that it shifts through, and I have the shade here. Let's talk about this one first, and this is From the Moon. You do get an imprint of Luna here, and this one is a nice, pretty pink shade. I don't usually gravitate towards these type of blue-based pinks. This is really, really bright. But if you are a blush lover, this is a great addition to the collection because it kind of just brings out the liveliness to your cheeks. And I like the fact that this is also all matte, because in the same token, you also get one that has some shimmers in it. So you do get variety and you do get options in this collection, which I really like. Plus, it kind of gives me a way to compare the two formulas because I've never tried blushes from ColourPop. Now this one that I'm holding up here is Cat's Eye, and this one is a beautiful coral peach, and this one has a little bit of golden sheen to it. Now I feel like comparing the two, it's kind of hard to tell on the skin, quite honestly, because when you blend it out and sheer it out, they almost look the same, and I think the only difference really is the matte and shimmer finish. To the touch, these are very dry, but with a brush, it blends on the skin evenly, it's seamless. For this look here, I did use Cat's Eye, and it kind of just flows with me. And I didn't do a whole bunch, I kind of just did a couple of taps. And although it looks so bright and pink here, on the cheeks, it's a little bit more subdued, it's a little bit lighter, and it just brightens up the cheek. I do hope that they restock everything, because there are a lot of people who DM'd me and who were like, I really wish I got the blushes, but they sold out so fast. So these are something that everyone is eyeing. So if you are thinking, okay, I want the blush, when they have a restock, if they do, then definitely get your hands on it, because it is something that is selling out like hotcakes. Let's talk glitters. These are called the Glitterly Obsessed Glitters. Now these are not meant for your eyes, so that's why I didn't put them on my eyes and I only swatched it on my arm to show you guys. Now they do have 2 shades in this collection. One of them is a purple, and this is Moon Prism Power, and then the other one is a pink, and that is Moonlight Legend. Now I have a lot to say about these because you're not supposed to wear them on the eyes, so I wanted to go ahead and talk about how it is on the skin. Now I had them on my skin for like almost an hour, and I am still having residue on my arm. These do not move. Once they set, they are there to stay. So my question is, are these biodegradable glitters? And I only really bring that up as a review question because I know some people are so much more environmentally conscious than I am, and I just wonder, because it is so hard to remove, that I just wonder if this is something that I have to take off in the shower, because it just seems like wipes don't really work, makeup remover doesn't really work, so I just don't know, okay. But let's go ahead and talk a little bit more in depth about these glitters. Now, as you saw in the swatches, the Moon Prism Power Glitter is a purple gel, and then it also has some circle glitters, as well as moon glitters and star glitters, and I just think that that is so pretty. A part of me just wants to nitpick some of the stars and the moons and then just put that around my eyes. I think that would be cute. I don't know how that would go, but it sounds like a fun time. And then the Moonlight Legend Legend one is a pink gel, and the glitters in here have almost a holographic shift to them, but I don't know if I want to call it holographic because I don't really see a lot of red shifts to it, because when I look at it in the light, it seems to reflect a lot more blue, greens, and yellows. But that kind of is a cool little addition to this entire collection. It's not my favorite because it doesn't have the other types of glitters in here other than just the circle glitters. Let's talk about some lips. So we have two lip bundles here, and first we have Moonlight, which has the Bun Head Ultra Blotted Lip and the Sailor Moon Ultra Glossy Lip. The next bundle that we have is the Daylight Lip Bundle, which has the Usagi Ultra Blotted Lip and Moon Tiara Ultra Glossy Lip. Now, when I am wearing pinks, I tend to just not like it when I first apply it because I just feel like it's not me. It's not how I jive. But these ones, I feel like although they are bright, I think that they are still wearable because it is the Ultra Blotted formula. Now, I haven't tried the Ultra Blotted formula prior to this collection, so I took it upon myself to pop my Ultra Blotted Cherry with this collection. I think it was a great idea. I think I was smart. It was a good choice. If you're somebody who likes a lip tint but can't really commit to the staining, then I think that this is a great formula because it kind of just makes your lips look naturally flushed. And I think right now I have never liked pink better on me, in my opinion, because it just looks so natural. Now, I feel like the ultra glossy lips, a lot of people tend to stay away from them because they find it very thick, sticky, and in my opinion, if you just apply a little bit in the center of the lips and then move it around to the rest of your lip with your finger, I think that that really thins it out, makes it a lot more comfortable, and just easier to wear, in my opinion. So I recommend these, just applying it with the applicator and then moving it around with the lips for both of these lip products, because I feel like then it kind of just gives you that soft, kissable look. And because this is more of like a soft pink lip, I feel like once it starts to fade, it's not going to be like pink and then your natural lip color. It's going to have a nice gradient, and you can go longer without touch-ups, which I think is really nice as well. And before I wrap up this review, I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys both of the tutorials for Sailor Mars and Sailor Moon.
Yeah.
And just like that, you guys, that wraps up my review on the Sailor Moon and ColourPop collection. I hope you guys found some of my insights helpful, and I hope that if you don't like something, then you are able to work it in a different way. I feel like with this collection, there were some hits and then there were some misses in some areas. Like, the palette wasn't 100% perfect, but the color scheme was really nice. I also found that these ones were kind of confusing. The glitters, I don't really know when I'm gonna wear them. But we'll see. We'll find out. The glossy lip and the ultra blotted lip, I do have to finesse it with my finger. It's not 100% where I could just slap it on and go. I'm gonna have to sit there and actually work with it. And then the blushes, I think those are foolproof. Those, you could just apply it and it'll look really good. So, you know, there were hits and there were misses in this collection, but I'm always going to be honest and upfront about it, and just so you guys can see where I'm at and we can compare if we have the same issues or not. As always, I love you guys so much. Thank you guys so much for watching this review, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye! Peace out, Girl Scouts!